Hi there. My name is Mark Hall, and I am Hallmark.
So, tell me about your life.
Okay, so my name is Mark Hall. I come from the illustrious Hall family in Christmasville, United States of America. Now you may ask, hey, where is Christmasville, United States of America? And I say, the FBI has recommended I do not share my true face or location as to not aware any suspicious people of me and my family's whereabouts. So, anyways, why was I moved here? I was moved to Shrewsbury High School from Christmasville. I miss you, Christmasville. Was because my parents were under the job Christmas tree lovers, which according to the IRS is not a viable source of income and not a reason to own $75 million. What am I gonna wear? What am I going to wear? I don't have anything to wear. I don't even have a tuxedo picked out.
What are you freaking out about?
Are you stupid? The wedding.
What wedding?
Are you serious? I saw a boy bump into a girl, and then the boy helped pick up her books. I have 2 weeks to get a wedding together because they're gonna get married, as is tradition in Article 8 of Christmasville law.
So, Mark, what are some differences that you've noticed?
Between Hallmark Christmasville and Shrewsbury High School? Well, okay. Well, besides everyone being angry, sad, depressed, hungry, angry, sad, depressed, do you want to know what the number one thing is? So what I do, as it's Christmasville tradition, is I go up to everyone and I say, Merry Christmas, all! Aren't you excited for the holiday season? And I've gotten such vulgar responses as, I'm in the bathroom, and it's April. So I don't know what's going on around here, but it seems to have a severe lacking of Christmas spirit.
So overall, do you like it here?
I've never said no to anything before. It's not Christmas tradition. But no. I don't even know who I am anymore.
Cut the cameras!
So, this is the director, and I think he's having a mental breakdown right now.
I don't even know who I am anymore!
So, it's been 10 minutes, and I think he's freaking out.
Bojoyous day! Hey!
What happened?
I discovered the real meaning of the holidays. So basically, when I was in my, I call it my rebellious era, I made a decision. I have an idea. I'm gonna go to Google. And I was going to look up the real meaning of Christmas. Yet, when I looked up CH, I looked up KR. Because guess what? What am I, a genius? How do I know how to spell Christmas? What, I lived in Christmasville. That doesn't mean I know how to spell Christmas. I'm not Albert Einstein. Don't judge me. But it auto-corrected to this amazing man. And his name is Krampus. My goodbye message to all of you, after so much time and research living in the Christmasville, forget Christmas. Endorse Krampus. Merry Christmas, Krampus, all. Wow, can't believe I haven't seen him around.
Yeah, I wonder why it... Oh, well, hi.
Hi, my name is Ethan Brown, and welcome to the Shrewsbury High School Not So Very Late Show.
And I'm Kaylee Gale. Thank goodness it's the holiday season. The break is very much needed.
What about the holidays themselves? The spirit of the holidays always has me ready to go.
Is it the gifts?
Yeah, it's the gifts. Well, anyways, Kaylee here went around Shrewsbury High School asking people about their favorite holiday things. Let's check it out.
What's your favorite holiday movie?
Home Alone.
Home Alone.
Charlie Brown Thanksgiving. Elf.
Home Alone. Home Alone. Oh, this is basic. Home Alone. I can't think of anything else. Die Hard. My favorite holiday movie is The Grinch. For me, I would say Elf.
Probably Home Alone.
Oh, I like Charlie Brown.
Home Alone.
Okay. Sledding.
Home Alone.
Home Alone.
What's your favorite winter activity?
I like skiing.
Skiing.
Sledding.
Baking cookies.
Skiing.
I love snowboarding. I like skiing.
Sledding.
Ice skating.
Running.
Running.
Skiing.
Ice skating.
Skiing, for sure.
Skiing.
Making gingerbread houses.
Sledding.
Sleeping.
Sitting by the fireplace.
What's your favorite holiday food?
I'm gonna have to say hot chocolate.
Chocolate crinkle cookies.
I'd say, like, making hot chocolate.
Oh, same, hot chocolate.
My favorite holiday food is baklava,
Sour Patch Canned Canes,
hot cocoa.
Wow, what an amazing summary of the holiday season. Now, I take you to tonight's special guest, Cooper Fox.
Welcome to the Cooper Fox Show. Today, we're gonna be learning how to draw a face.
Oh, I brought a model? Can I?
No.
Okay.
We're gonna be learning how to draw our faces.
Okay.
First, I'm gonna start off by
blue?
Drawing the shape of my face.
Okay, I can do that.
Nice and chiseled.
Yeah.
Nice and oval, you know?
Next,
we're gonna draw the guidelines,
How do I do that?
You put the lines where the guidelines should be.
Where should the guidelines be?
You got a line where the nose is, where the eyes are,
okay.
Where the mouth will be.
Oh, okay, that makes sense, okay.
You know.
That makes sense, I can do that.
Where are you supposed to put them?
It's easy.
Then, let's draw some eyes.
Eyes.
You know?
Ooh.
You just make that shape. Let's put the pupils in. You know, all right, we got some eyes. Gotta have eyelids in there, you know.
Wait, I'm not done.
Okay, I'm gonna move on.
Can we slow down?
You're doing great.
Let's
move on to the nose. The nose, yeah.
Nose.
We get the nose in there. Sometimes there's a little line like that, you know.
Okay.
All right.
I can do that.
Let's give it some eyebrows in there.
How do I? I don't think. Is that how you draw an eyebrow?
I got some really bushy eyebrows. Okay.
Wait.
This is looking great. Let's draw.
Wait, I think you're going too fast. I don't know if the audience, you know, I don't think they
incredible.
Can
you're doing
keep up.
Incredible.
I can keep up.
You're doing incredible too.
I can.
Let's add in a mouth.
Mouth.
I'm smiling because I always smile.
Same. I smile too, all the time.
We're gonna add in some hair, you know. I got some great hair.
I can do that.
You know. That is some great hair.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
You know.
Okay. Wow, I think this is looking pretty good actually. I'm feeling good about this. This is good.
Let's put some more in here, you know.
What are you doing?
I'm just like adding a little extra, you know.
You
know what I mean.
No, I don't.
You know what I mean.
No.
Okay.
No.
Is looking
yeah.
just like me, you know.
Color.
Okay.
This isn't working.
You're doing incredible.
Can I draw like a body? Can I do my Christmas sweater?
No. Okay. Let's give him a neck. Oh my bad.
A neck?
Let's give him a neck.
How do I do
a
neck?
I think it should be done with crayon. You should do it in crayon.
That's the only crayon.
I think you should do it in crayon.
You're a crayon. God.
I said you should use the crayon.
Oh, okay. I'll use the crayon.
Okay. I'm wearing a nice Sheen sweatshirt in this, you know.
I'm going to draw my Christmas hat.
Does Sheen sell sweatshirts? Okay. And the final touch.
Wait, I'm not done with my
A little flare. No, you're doing great.
No, I'm not done. Oh, wait. I can scribble. I can scribble. Ready? I can scribble. I can do this. This is the one thing I can do.
You just feel the flow of the
what
pens.
What flow?
Happy little lines. You know, don't you just love that artistic flow?
I don't think I'm getting this down.
I think you're doing great. You're doing great. Let's get that. It's perfect.
What?
Perfect. We're almost finished. Okay.
All right. Well, I know some people at home loved that. Well,
they're almost done, so you came to me. And now, are you excited to see the results, or are you excited to see those results? Let's take a look.
All right.
Oh.
No, we just finished.
What? That's not what mine looks like. When did that happen?
Yours looks great. Yours is looking
great. Is that even Sharpie?
Yeah. You know, it's that you gotta just use your wrist to do it. It's not the arm, it's the movement of the wrist.
I drew a Christmas sweater. It's
happy little lines, you know?
Yeah, I know.
You did great. Now, thank you for watching The Cooper Fox Show. Tune in next week when we draw my face again. Thank you.
What a great painting, Cooper. And Kaylee's, yours was all right. And while holiday art is always fun, so are the movies. Let's take a look at some movie trailers starring some familiar SHS faces. And when we come back, it's holiday trivia time.
It didn't feel wrong. It never felt wrong. If you lived through what I did, would you still be alive? I have something for you. I've been having dreams. Dreams of Willow trying to kill me.
Have you seen Willow? Aren't they just so weird?
Yeah, they're always staring. Jeez, what's wrong with them?
Where have you been? I've been waiting for an hour.
I said 4, not 3.
It's almost complete.
Sorry, I have plans.
Body never felt so good.
Something in the way. Something in the way. Yeah.
Brittany has no wrist.
What a loser.
Coming this summer.
Dude, get up here. We got places to go.
Get up.
A coming-of-age film. Dude, bro, I got someone you need to meet.
I am a cop!
Do not bully. Well,
you can't tell. What if it is Riz?
Welcome, chosen warriors. Each and every one of you have been selected by one of the 12 Olympian gods. You will battle in the games under your god's name and along with the help of their strength. Many of you will die, and only one of you will live. This is your brand new reality.
We have to accept this. Our lives have changed.
Now all we have to do is fight.
Only one of us can make it out of here.
Run. You have to survive.
There's a reason I was chosen by Ares, you know. It's simply because I'm the strongest.
Are we just here to die for the gods?
No. I'm here to kill for them.
Welcome back. I'm Marash Mobani, here for your holiday trivia game. Today, joining us, we have the SHS crew team versus the SHS crew team. Let's get started. The rules are simple. The first to raise your screen is the first to answer the question. You get the question right, you win points. You win more points, you win the game. You win the game, you're the best part of the crew team.
Yeah!
All right, let's get going. First question. When was the first Olympic rowing competition held? 1996, 1896, or 1900? I'll repeat, 1996, 1896, or 1900. That's gonna go to the boys.
1896.
1896, is that your final answer?
Yep.
That is incorrect.
Yes.
Would the girls like to steal?
Yes, we would like to steal.
All right.
Our answer is 1900.
That is your final answer?
That is our final answer.
And that is correct.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Sell it. You're selling.
That's going to be 10 points to the girls' team. Oh.
Two. Okay. Easy 10.
Okay. All right. Slide. Next question. Because you need help. What is the name of the vehicle that on Christmas Eve takes little children to the North Pole to meet Santa Claus? I saw the boys first.
The Polar Express.
Let's
go.
Yeah.
Let's go.
All right. Tied 10-10. All right. Next question. Got a pop culture one for you now.
Ooh.
What is the name of the president who cameoed and Home Alone 2. Wait until I finish. All right, we'll give that to the girls.
Oh. Donald Trump.
Is that your final answer?
Yes, it is.
It is Donald
Trump.
Yes.
Yes.
That's gonna be 2010. Remember to raise your thing after I ask the question. All right.
Oh man, lock in.
Next question. Merry Christmas, you filthy animals. Is a quote said by whom? In what movie?
Oh.
Girl?
Kevin McAllister from Home Alone?
That is correct.
Yes!
No, it's originally said by the... It said the movie. And the movie he watches is first, right?
No, the movie that it's from. The movie that the quote itself is from.
Oh, I thought... Never mind.
That's all right. Plenty of game left to go. Next question.
We locked in.
This is a crew question for the crew teams, very appropriate. One person in the boat sets the stroke rate and the tempo. In addition to technical skill, they also have to be very strong. What is the name of the position? Saw the boys first.
The stroke seat or me?
Me.
It is the stroke seat.
Let's see.
Extra.
Yeah, James, can you have a demonstration of what the stroke seat does? Just get right in the truck. That is what the stroke seat does. Let's go. All right, next question.
Yeah, let's go, big boy.
Who?
This is going to be another crew question.
Ooh.
How does crew differ from paddling sports? I saw the girls first.
Can we repeat the question?
How does crew differ from other paddling sports?
Other paddling sports?
Yes.
For one, there is a slide, so you're sitting on a seat that has wheels on it that go back and forth.
And there's also someone who steers the boat as long as the rowers. Other teams don't have that. Other paddling things don't have that. Yep.
All right. Any other differences? There's one key difference that we're looking for.
Key difference. There's a rudder.
Anything else?
Hannah.
All right, we're gonna give it to the boys.
Use your legs.
Because like in crew, you're like driving off the pool place with your legs.
These are all differences. There's just one. There is one key difference, which is that the paddles are not connected in paddle boats. The rowing oars are connected via the oar locks.
Oh.
That's all right, nobody got that. Still anybody's game, long game ahead of us. Let's go. It's all right.
I think neither of us get points lost or gained.
That's fine. No points lost, no points gained. Still a long game ahead of us. All right, next question. This is going to be our very first finish a lyric. All right, ready? When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm.
Can we repeat with the saying or?
When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going out in the storm.
But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm.
That is correct.
Yay. Good job, Shai.
All right. Next question is going to be another finish the lyric. Very popular song. Let's see who gets this. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. Is that the next lyric?
That is the right song, not the right lyric. Would the boys like to steal?
Can you repeat that, please?
You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile.
Oh, if I had to choose between you and the crocodile, I'd choose the crocodile.
Is that your final answer?
Something along those lines.
Yeah. Very close.
I'd choose the seasick crocodile.
The actual lyrics are, Mr. Grinch, given the choice between you, I'd take the seasick crocodile. Very close. Very close.
It don't matter.
Yeah.
Stay champions.
All right, let's go with another question.
No reaction.
According to CNBC, the most popular meat for a Christmas feast in America, Ireland, the UK, and Canada is? Boys?
Ham.
Incorrect.
A roast.
Also incorrect.
What?
Sure. Lamb.
What? The correct answer is
iceberg.
Turkey.
What?
There's no way.
I've never had turkey.
I've never had a turkey.
Your wrong information.
All right, next question.
They have turkeys over there.
It's fine. Still anybody's game, really.
Still gets it right.
This is going to be a culture question about the Christmas tree. The star that used on a topper on Christmas trees is a reference to A, the Star of David, B, the sun, or C, the star over Bethlehem.
Can we repeat of A?
The Star of David, the sun, or the star over Bethlehem.
The Star of Bethlehem?
It is the Star of Bethlehem.
Yes.
That's good, a point for the girls.
Bah.
It's all right. Next question.
I've been asking again.
Gonna try and pick a doozy here. Another crew question.
Oh no.
What are the two rowing disciplines?
Sculling and sweeping.
Sculling and sweeping. Is that your final answer?
Yes.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah. That's what it's called.
Are you sure that is your final answer?
Yeah.
That is correct.
Yeah!
I don't know.
Yes, sir.
All right. We're doing good, doing good.
Yes, we are.
Mrs. Herbert, could we have the score, please?
Oh, please.
The score is girls at 50, boys at 30.
Yes!
Very close game, very close game. And how much time do we have left?
We got this, we got this.
Our champions, close your eyes. We're back in.
Final 500.
It's easy.
We have enough time for this game to go in anybody's direction. That is how much time. Next question.
Guys, focus.
This is going to be a pop culture question. What is the first of the four ghosts that Ebenezer Scrooge encounters in Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol?
The ghost of Christmas past.
That is incorrect.
What?
It's what his boys old... like to steal?
Yes. It's his... Oh, sorry. I'm sorry.
No.
It's his old business partner, Jacob Marley. Yeah.
Is that your final answer?
That is my final answer. Yeah.
It is Jacob
Marley. Marley! I love the Muppets.
You know, I think that for this next question, I say we do a double points. All right. This is for all the marbles. This is for the winner of the ultimate holiday game trivia show. This is for the best part of the crew team, the boys or the girls. And your question is, the Jewish festival of Hanukkah always begins on the 25th of Kislev in the Hebrew calendar and lasts 8 days after. This year, Hanukkah ends on A, December 15th, B, December 22nd, or 3, January 2nd.
Yes.
That was the boys.
December 15th.
December 15th. Final answer?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Final answer to the double point question. And the winner of our game between the boys and the girls cruising.
Come on.
For the ultimate winner of the Holiday Game Fest is the boys.
Let's go! Yeah!
Let's go!
Thank you for joining us today. Thank you so much. And now we would like to toss it back. We would like to toss it forward, actually, to our next package.
Hello, everyone,
and welcome to
the Snow Show. I'm Dr. Arthur V.
And I'm Dr. Brayden Tonelli. Today, we were supposed to have a third host, but
he was a snow show.
Anyways, we did rehire one of our personnel. They bring us the food. Let's hope they don't mess up this time, right?
Yeah.
All right. On to our first snack. These are sugar cookies.
Hmm.
On three, right? One, two, three. It's dry. It's drier than the winter season. What do you rate it?
8.73 out of 12.
5.7 out of 12.
It has a certain dryness to it, at least mine.
Mine is really dry. I'll keep eating it, though.
Unfortunately, I think this will be on the lower end of the total amount of...
This ice it. This is not it.
Mm-hmm.
Next one.
Let's hope this next one's better.
Yeah. These are snowballs.
Huh.
These are... Well, that brr sights.
This was utterly fantastic.
Nuts. A lot of nuts. I like it.
There's a certain elegantness to this that makes me want to rate it 12 out of 12, but that's impossible. It has to be an 11.9. What would you say?
I'll give it a 10, mainly because I love snowballs.
Me too. Me too, Braden.
Well, that was a good one. Mm-hmm. Should we move on to the next?
Let's do that.
Well, on to our next one, right?
Mm-hmm. Number 3.
I don't know what these are. They look like cookies.
Because they are.
I got pretzel.
I don't know what you think, but for me personally, it's hard to raise the burr here, but I would rate this an 11 out of 12. I don't know if you're going to say the same.
This shrunk my heart 3 sizes. I don't like them. They taste like...
On to the next one, then.
All right. On to our next product.
Number 4.
Popcorn. Didn't open it for us.
Your job's on the line here.
Oh no.
It's really on the line. A frosty line.
At the same time?
Oh, you got me one? Thanks,
Sorry.
Bro.
Yeah, I got you.
Cheers. Okay. Cheers. Huh.
I think this is a 9 out of 12.
9 out of 12?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
You agree with me?
I agree with you.
Oh my God.
Oh man.
I'm not going
to kill you. I'm not going to kill you.
Okay. This, awesome. Probably the first thing we'll finally agree on in our marriage.
Here comes the 5th item, which he has dropped.
You're on thin ice, dude. Okay.
Oh. Let's eat off the top, which is a little safer.
Oh, I'll get the... Interesting texture. Mm. Wet. It smells like blueberries.
All hope is not frost with this one. I give this an 8.4. I have 12.
I give it a 7.6 out of 12. Mainly because there's raisins in this holiday muffin. All right. On to the next one. On to our next product. Something very interesting.
It's
what
quite
are these?
Peculiar.
Oh, God. There's no hope with this.
There's no point in rating this. I just can't.
Well, we have to. It's our job.
Negative 12 out of 12.
0.01 continuing out of 12.
I don't want to see this one ever again.
If there is a snow miser, help us all. And on to our next product. Snowman marshmallows. How about we break it off like a wishbone?
Yeah.
I got a wish.
Okay.
I wish for more puppies.
Okay. This is ice, man. Oh, really ice. I like the consistency of sugar.
It's quite peculiar in taste. It's a little too sweet for me, but its texture is nice, I must admit.
I usually like letting them harden, and then I bite into them. But they're soft, and I like it. Look how squishy they are.
Just because of that, I'm giving it a 6 out of 12.
I'm going to give it something we have never done before. A 12.1 out of 12.
That's illegal.
When we started this business, we established we could rate it as much as we want.
Well, I only meant that in negatives, not above 12.
Sometimes a 12 above is what is needed to express the love for marshmallows.
On to the next one. I'm done with this.
I'm done with you. On to our next product.
Did you take a bite out of this?
There's no way you did this.
Please, man, it was an accident.
You?
You barely pay me.
Are fired.
What?
Fired.
No, wait, not yet. If this is good, you won't fire him. Huh. Better be good, Declan.
For your family's sake.
This frost bites. It's up to you now. What do you think? Should we keep this poor, disgusting man?
Your children are getting presents this year.
For once.
No.
Leave.
And never return.
Anyways, that concludes our wonderful
snow show.
Have a great day, everyone.
And a good Christmas, too.
And every other holiday.
Wow, what a show it's been, huh?
You bet. That must have been one of our most exciting yet. The incredible painting, the holidays, the trivia.
Well, Cooper's painting was awesome. But let's not forget the best part, the holidays.
I already... You know,
what?
In the name of the holidays, I won't yell at you. Thank you all for watching, and have a happy holidays.
Merry Christmas. Kaylee.